Hello everyone. Now, this is the time that we should discuss commission to a partner. Now, what is commission to a partner? Commission to a partner is allowed for rendering some extra time to the business or discharging duties with dedication. If a partner is doing his duties with dedication, then also commission is allowed. Doing some extra work. There are many reasons for which commission can be given, but these are the main reasons. Now, what are the journal entries? You know that commission is an expense for the firm and income for the partners. If it is an income for the partners, then it will increase partners' capital. Partners' commission is an expense for the firm. If expense increase, it is debited. It is an income for the partners, so partners' capital will be credited. Capital increase means it will be credited. Now, if we are following fluctuating capital method, then A's capital, B's capital. If we are following current account method, or we can say fixed capital method, then in that case, to A's current account, to B's current account. Being commission paid to partners. Now, at the end of the year, we transfer all the partners related items to P&L appropriation account. So, P&L appropriation account debit to partners commission account. These are the journal entries which we have already discussed in previous videos. Now, the most important thing in commission is that how to calculate commission. There are two cases. Number first, commission as a percentage of net profit before charging such commission. Now, in this case, you have to calculate commission from that profit from which no such commission has been deducted. Now, we have to calculate commission in which net profit is given before charging any commission, and you have to calculate the commission from that profit only. So in this case, commission is before charging commission, net profit is also before charging commission into rate upon 100. Therefore, formula is simple. Commission equals to net profit into rate upon 100. Both items are before and before. Case second. Commission is a percentage of net profit after charging such commission. In this case, you have to calculate commission from that profit from which commission has already been deducted. So, net profit after charging such commission. The commission that you are calculating is already deducted from this profit. So, in this case, if you want to calculate commission after charging such commission, then both items are after and after. So the formula will remain same as above. Net profit after charging commission into rate upon 100. Now this is simple. Before commission, before profit, formula is commission equals to net profit into rate upon 100. After commission, after profit, formula is simple. Commission equals to net profit into rate upon 100. Now the problem arises when we have to deal with a special case in which net profit is given before charging any commission, but you have to calculate the commission after charging such commission. Now in this case, you have been given the input by the question as net profit before charging any such commission, which you are now to calculate. You have to calculate commission by after charging. In that case, to convert before into after, you will be modifying the formula as follows. Commission after charging commission equals to net profit before charging such commission into rate upon 100 plus rate. This is very important. Generally, questions are asked by this method only. In this method, the amount of commission will be less as compared to the above methods. Okay, now let us do some questions relating to these commissions. क्वेश्चन वन, अंजलि, एनी एंड आयुषी वर शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट्स इन द रेशियो ऑफ 1:1:1 इक्वल पार्टनर्स. एनी वॉज एंटाइटल्ड टू रिसीव अ कमीशन ऑफ 10% ऑन नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर चार्जिंग सच कमीशन. नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर चार्जिंग द कमीशन पेबल टू एनी वॉज 9,70,000. कैलकुलेट कमीशन पेबल टू एनी एंड शो पीएनएल एप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट. ओके, नाउ सॉल्यूशन. सॉल्यूशन वन, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर कमीशन? नाउ फॉर्मूला फॉर कमीशन इज नेट प्रॉफिट इनटू रेट अपॉन 100. नाउ हियर द कमीशन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इट इज बिफोर चार्जिंग सच कमीशन. And the net profit that has been given to you is also before charging. Therefore, net profit is 9,70,000. What is the rate? Rate is 10%. So, answer comes to 97,000 rupees. Commission. Okay. Therefore, Annie's commission equals to 97,000. Now, how we will show this in profit and loss appropriation account? Now, net profit, profit and loss account, net profit is 9,70,000. Okay. Now, there is one expense to Annie's commission that we have calculated 97,000 rupees. Now balancing 9,70,000. Here comes 9,70,000. Now deduct 97,000 from 9,70,000. 9,70,000 minus 97,000. Now 8,73,000 is a profit. To profit transfer to capital accounts. Partners are Anjali, Annie, Ayushi. Now they are equal partners, means the profit of 8,73,000 will be distributed in the ratio of 1:1:1. Means each partner will get 1/3 share. Okay. Now 3 to 6. 3 9 27. 3 1 3 0 0 0. That means each partner will get 2,91,000 rupees. Question one is short. Now question two. Bindiya, Chavi and Isha are sharing profits in the ratio of 2:2:1. Okay. That means Bindiya and Chavi have more share in the firm than Isha. Isha was entitled to receive a commission of 10% on net profit after charging such commission. After charging such commission. Commission is after. Net profit before charging such commission payable to Isha. Now net profit is before and the commission that you have to calculate it is after. And the net profit is 8,80,000. Show profit and loss appropriation account. Henceforth, you have to first calculate Isha's commission. Now, solution second. Isha's commission after is to be calculated and net profit is given for before. Then the formula is rate upon 100 plus rate. If commission is to be calculated for after and net profit is given for before. In that case, I have taught you that the formula will change or modify as per the requirements here, rate upon 100 plus rate. So net profit is 8,80,000 and the rate is 10% upon 100 plus 10. Therefore 8,80,000 into 10 upon 110. 11,8 is 88, therefore commission comes to 80,000 rupees. Now P&L appropriation will be by net profit. You can write it either way, like this or like this. Now your net profit is 8,80,000. Now here expenses to Isha's commission. ₹80,000. Now balancing 8,80,000 is higher. 8,80,000 minus 80,000 comes 8,00,000 rupees profit. Now this profit will be distributed amongst partners. Partners are Bindiya, Chavi and Isha. And the profit is 8,00,000 rupees. Now the ratio is 2:2:1. Therefore 2+2, 4, 4+1, 5. 8,00,000 divided by 5. 5 is 5. 5, 6 is 30. Here comes 1,60,000 rupees. 1,60,000 into 1 equals to 1,60,000. 1,60,000 into 2, 3,20,000. 1,60,000 into 2, again 3,20,000. Now Isha gets a commission of 80,000 and Isha gets a profit of 1,60,000 and Bindiya and Chavi gets a profit of 3,20,000 each. Now the last question. Jia, Khushi and Madhvi were sharing profits in the ratio of 3:3:2. Jia was entitled to receive a commission of 10% on net profit after charging the commission payable to Jia. Okay, she is entitled to receive a commission. Jia is entitled to receive a commission by after charging method. Net profit is also given after charged. Net profit after charging the commission payable to Jia was 16,00,000 rupees. Calculate the commission payable to Jia and show P&L account. Now this is an important case. Solution 3. Now here, Jia is entitled to receive a commission. Jia's commission is needed after charging such commission. And net profit is also given after charging. So the formula will be simple. Rate upon 100. Net profit into rate upon 100. Before and before, rate upon 100. After and after, rate upon 100. After to before, rate upon 100 plus rate. Now in this case, profit is 16,00,000 into 10%. 1,60,000 is your answer. Okay, now the important part is how it will be represented in P&L appropriation account. Now here net profit is needed, but this net profit should be before charging such commission or any other expenses which are relating to partners, like salary, interest on capital, interest on drawings, any item. Now I have taught you that here the net profit is always for before charging any such commission or expenses. So here 16 lakh is the profit after charging such commission. So such commission will be added back. Commission is 1,60,000 rupees. Now the correct answer is 17,60,000 rupees. The correct net profit before charging any such commission or expenses is 17,60,000. This is the most important part. Okay, now this is settled and we will be doing the question as usual. Two. GS commission 1,60,000 rupees. Now the total is 17,60,000 rupees. 17,60,000 rupees. 17,60,000 minus 1,60,000 comes to 16,00,000 rupees, which will be distributed as profit between the partners. To profit, transfer to capital account of partners. Now the partners are Jia, Khushi and Madhvi. Now what is the ratio? Ratio is 3:3:2. 3+3 = 6, 6+2 = 8. Okay. Now 1,00,000. Now 16,00,000 will be divided by 8. 8 to the 16. Here comes 2,00,000. Now 2,00,000 into 3. 3 to the 6,00,000. Same. And 2 to the 4. 4,00,000. Therefore 16,00,000. Now we have dealt the commission part and also how they will be represented in P&L appropriation account.